Okay, so in this video, I'll be telling you about something called range of sine magnitude representation. Okay, so I forgot to tell you about this in the previous video. Actually, it is equally important. It's not like you can represent any number of any magnitude or any number of bits you can represent with sine magnitude representation. There is a limit, actually. Okay, so there is a positive limit and negative limit depends upon the number of bits you have. Okay, so it's not like you can represent an something thousand or lakhs or something with this sine magnitude, positive or negative. I mean, you have to be, this is decimal by the way, okay, you have to have a, you should be knowing the range within which you can represent the numbers. Okay, so I'll tell you the range. It depends upon the bits. Okay, so its range is, this is the range of sine magnitude representation. It is minus 2 to the power n minus 1 minus 1. This is in power, this is not, 2 to the power n minus 1 minus 1. Okay, where n is the number of bits. Okay, so for example, if I have 4 bits, n is equal to 4. Then what will be the range? Means the range will be minus 2 to the power 4 minus 1 minus 1 to 2 to the power 4 minus 1 minus 1. This will be 2 to the power 3 minus 1 to 2 to the power 3 minus 1. That is 8 minus 1 7 minus 7 to 3 2 to the 4 4 to the 8 minus 1 7. Okay, this is the decimal number. So with n equal to 4, if you want to represent the numbers in sine magnitude, the range will be from minus 7 to plus 7. In between, whatever the number comes, minus 6, 6, 0, 2, minus 2, these all things you can represent via sine magnitude representation if you have n equal to 4. Okay, that's the range. Outside this will be like overflow, or you can say something called error. Okay, because the range is between minus 7 to 7 and you are generating a result, let's say 5 plus 5, you are generating 10 and the range is between minus 7 to 7, then how you wanna represent 10? That's kind of scenario here for sine magnitude. Whereas if it would have been binary representation, you could have easily represented 10 with 4 a number of bits. Okay, so that's the important part. So you have to keep the range in your head. Okay, let's take another example. So let's say if you want to have n equal to 7, then what will be the range? So it will be minus 2 to the power 7 minus 1 minus 1 2 plus 2 to the power 7 minus 1 minus 1. So this will be 2 to the power 6 minus 1 2 2 to the power 6 minus 1. What is 2 to the power 6? 2 to the 4, 4 to 8, 16, 32, 32. No, 64. 64 minus 1 2 64 plus minus 1. This will be minus 63 to plus 63. That will be the range. Means with n equal to 7, if you have 7 bits in your hand, then how many, what will be the range of numbers you can represent via sine magnitude? From minus 63 to 63. Okay. And when I am telling you n equal to 7 means 0, 1, 2, something like this kind of representation you can think of. Any representation, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, total it should be 7 bits. Okay, here I am not just considering the magnitude bits separate and sine bits separate, total overall bits should be 7. Okay, I am not considering only the magnitude bit or sine bit separate, it is total number of bits, total number of bits, total total number of bits, how many you have in your hand. I have 7 number of bits. So what will be the range from where I can represent the number in sign magnitude, this is the range from minus 63 to 63. This is decimal numbers, okay? This is decimal number. One more example you can take. I think you got the point. I'll take a smaller one. So let's say n equal to 2, then 2 to the power 2 minus 1 minus 1, 2. 2 to the power 2 minus 1 minus 1. This will be 2 minus 1, 2 to the power 1, 2 minus 1. So this will be minus 1, 2 plus 1. This will be the range. Okay, with n equal to 2, if you have 2 bits in your hand, so let's say you have 2 bits on your hand, then you can represent from minus 1 to plus 1. Okay, that's the range of sign magnitude representation. Outside this range, you will have invalid numbers. Okay, that you won't be able to see it because you are working in binary. So always keep in your head that there is a range associated with sign magnitude representation. Okay, yeah. One more thing. Okay, so 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1. I'll show you the example as well. Means if you have two bits, these are the possible combinations: 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1. This bit will be sign bit. Okay, so you can only represent two numbers: 0 0 or 0 1. This is 0. This is 1. If you will have 1 0. Then it will be minus 0. Okay, minus 0 is same as 0 only. If you have 1 1, this is minus 1. Okay, so minus 1 to plus 1, you can see minus 1, 0 and 1. Okay, these are the representation, because 0, minus 0 and 0 are same, so that's why it is consumed here only. So that's how you can imagine. So from a simple example you can imagine. So there is a left hand side as well of the 0, right hand side as well for of the 0, and that's how they are consuming the whole range. Okay, so I hope it is clear. When the value of n increases, it will become complicated to draw all the possibilities. So with this example you can see that there are negative numbers, positive numbers, and combined is the range. Okay, this is the range. This is for 2 to the power n minus 1, total number of bits. Okay, so that's the range for sign magnitude. Let's look at for other cases.